using the sub-elements of a sketch. This task shows you how to select different elements belonging to the same sketch for creating pads. You can download every file referred in the tutorial from the link given in the description. Open Pad 2 CAD part document. Click Pad. The Pad Definition dialog box is displayed. Click the selection field from the dialog box. Right-click and select Go to Profile Definition. The Profile Definition dialog box is displayed. You can define whether you need the whole geometry, that is the whole sketch, or sub-elements only. For the purposes of our scenario, check sub-elements if not already done. Select an edge. The sketch name as well as the edge name appear in the dialog box. The application also previews the pad. Click Add to add another element. Select an edge belonging to another profile. The application now previews this pad too. Click Add and this time select the edge belonging to the third profile. Select Edge 2 from the Starting Elements field and click Remove to remove the associated profile from the selection. Click OK to validate your selection. The Pad Definition dialog box reopens. You then just have to enter the parameters of your choice to extrude two profiles. Optionally click Preview before confirming the creation. Click OK to create the pad. If you encounter complex profiles causing ambiguity cases, the application lets you determine which lines you want to use. Click Pad. Right-click Profile Selection field and select Go to Profile Definition. Make sure that sub-elements is selected. The application detects an ambiguity as shown by the red symbol. The user can determine three different lines from this point. You can define the line you need to end the selection. Creating up to next pads. This task shows you how to create a pad using the up to next option. This creation mode lets the application detect the existing material to be used for trimming the pad. Open the Pad 3 CAD part document. Select the circle as the profile to be extruded. Click Pad. The Pad Definition dialog box appears and the application previews a pad with a default dimension value. Click the arrow in the geometry area to reverse the extrusion direction or click the reverse direction button. In the type field, set the option to up to next. This option assumes an existing face can be used to trim the pad. The application previews the pad to be created. The already existing body trims the extrusion. Optionally, click preview to see the result. Click OK. The pad is created. The specification tree indicates this creation. By default, the application extrudes normal to the plane used to create the profile. To learn how to change the direction, refer to Creating Pads Not Normal to Sketch Plane part of this tutorial. Creating up to last pads. This task shows how to create pads using the up to last option. Open the Pad 4 CAD part document. Select the circle as the profile to be extruded. Click Pad. The Pad Definition dialog box appears and the application previews a pad with 10 mm as the default dimension value. Click the arrow in the geometry area to reverse the extrusion direction or click the reverse direction button. In the type field, set the option to up to last. The last face encountered by the extrusion trims the pad. Optionally, click preview to see the result. Click OK. The pad is created.
The specification tree indicates this creation. Creating octoplane pads. This task shows how to create pads using the octoplane option. Open the Pad 5 CAD part document. Select the profile to be extruded. Click Pad. The Pad Definition dialog box appears and the application previews a pad with 10 mm as the default dimension value. In the Type field, set the type option to up to plane. Select Plane 1. The application previews the pad to be created. The plane trims the extrusion. An offset option is now available. Contextual commands creating the planes you need are available from the limit field. You can choose between create a plane and current coordinate system planes like XY, YZ and ZX planes. If you create a plane, the application then displays the plane icon in front of the limit field. Clicking this icon enables you to edit the element. Enter -20 as the offset value. This offset is the distance between the plane and the top face of the pad to be created. Optionally, click Preview to see the result. Click OK. The pad is created. The specification tree indicates this creation. Creating octosurface pads. This task shows you how to create pads using the octosurface option. Open the Pad 6 CAD part document. Select the profile to be extruded. Click Pad. The Pad Definition dialog box appears and the application previews a pad with a default dimension value. In the Type field, set the type option to up to surface. Select the vertical circular face. This face belongs to the same body as the existing pad. Using the up to surface option, you can select a face belonging to the same body as the sketch or a face belonging to part body. The face trims the extrusion. Contextual commands creating the surfaces you need are available from the limit field. You can choose between create join and create extrapol. If you create any of these elements, the application then displays the join or the extrapol icon in front of the limit field. Clicking this icon enables you to edit the element. An offset option is available in the dialog box. Enter -30 as the offset value. This offset is the distance between the surface and the top face of the pad to be created. Optionally, click Preview to see the result. Click OK. The pad is created. The specification tree indicates this creation. Creating pads from surfaces. This task explains how to extrude surfaces in any direction. Open the Thick Surface CAD part document. Select Extrude 1 as the surface to be extruded. Click Pad. The Pad Definition dialog box appears. You need to define an extrusion direction. To do so, either you select a geometric element or set the up to plane limit and select the plane of your choice. In that case, the direction will be given by the normal to that plane. Click the reference field and select plane 1 as the plane defining the extrusion direction. The direction is the normal to the plane. It is important that the surface to be extruded is not tangent to the extrusion direction or to the plane. For both limits to be defined, you can use all type options. Enter 21 mm and 11 mm as the first and second limit values respectively. Click OK to confirm. The new element is added to the specification tree. Creating pads not normal to sketch planes. This last task, about pad command, shows how to create a pad using a direction that is not normal to the plane used to create the profile. Open the pad 7 cat part document. Select the profile you wish to extrude. Click pad. The pad definition dialog box appears and the application previews the pad to be created. Set the up to plane option and select plane YZ. Click the more button to display the whole dialog box. Uncheck the normal to profile option and select the line as shown to use it as a reference. The application previews the pad with the new creation direction. Contextual commands creating the directions you need are available from the reference field. You can choose between create line, create plane and coordinate system axes. Click OK to confirm the creation. The pad is created. The specification tree indicates this creation.